Hi, this is Karl Polachuk from Small Biz Thoughts, and this is another SOP video for managed service providers. Today we're going to talk about DHCP and DNS and whether you should put them on the firewall or the server. Now, in the good old days, in particular with Small Business Server, but in general, the advice was that the old wisdom was that because of NetBUI, WINS, and LM hosts, you needed to make sure that the server managed DHCP and DNS, and that way the server always knew where everything was. Everybody could rely on the server. But that is, as I said, old wisdom. Since Active Directory was introduced, you have been discouraged from relying on NetBUI, LM hosts, and the WINS server. They all still work, but you need to use them less and less as time goes on. Now let's talk about what we mean by a firewall versus a router. So a router is, strictly speaking, a gateway. It is the last thing on your network before traffic moves from your network to another network. For 99% of us, maybe 99.99% of us, that gateway is actually a firewall. And then you get to the router, and then you get to the ISP, and then you get out to the rest of the world. So the firewall is what we're talking about when we talk about configuring a device to serve either DHCP or DNS. So there are three kinds of firewalls. There's the old junky kind that barely gets by and doesn't really do very much and costs $39, and you don't want to rely on that. You should just replace it under any circumstances. So clearly, you don't want that thing handing out DHCP or DNS. Two, you have a super fancy firewall. This is the kind that I like to sell that costs $3,000 and includes intrusion detection and all kinds of other stuff. It can do miracles, and that's a great firewall, and so that can serve up DHCP without any problems. Third, you have the basic firewall that's maybe $300-$500, maybe up to $1,000, and it has something called universal plug and play. That means it can be configured by the server through scripts to hand out DHCP with the appropriate scopes and inclusions and exclusions. It can point back to the server for DNS and so forth. So for most small businesses, you're going to want either number two or number three, the super fancy firewall handing out DHCP, or the universal plug and play firewall handing out DHCP. I will note, since 2008, it has been Microsoft's official recommendation that DHCP should be on the firewall or the router, the gateway, and not the server. In fact, since 2011, the default configuration for servers, even domain controllers, is that DHCP is not enabled by default. So, let's put an end to the debate and just serve DHCP off the firewall. What about DNS? Where does DNS live? Well, again, this has been a long-settled argument as far as Microsoft is concerned. Because you have Active Directory, DNS has to be on the server. So everyone in the network, everyone on your LAN, points to the server for DNS. The server then forwards out to some other DNS server. And I would call that a known good DNS server, by which I mean someone like Google or Microsoft or someone that you know and trust, and that address is not going to disappear. One of the problems you can have is that you'll set up DNS to point to the ISP, and the ISP changes their DNS and they never tell anybody. It's a very common thing, especially with really small ISPs. So then suddenly you've got all kinds of problems with your DNS, and it's because your ISP did something. Yes, there can be problems at Microsoft, there can be problems at Google, there can be problems at whatever, but if you pick what you consider to be a very reliable public DNS server and forward your requests to that, you will be in very good shape, and you don't have to worry about changing that configuration if you move to a new ISP. So the bottom line is DHCP on the gateway, on the firewall, universal plug and play if you've got it, DNS on the server. The server then forwards out to a known good DNS server. That's our tip for today. This is Karl Polachuk from Small Biz Thoughts, wishing you all the best in your managed service business.